Just over 2 weeks till the all-important midterm elections, and this week we're breaking down the big topics being debated in the race for U.S. Senate, plus new information on how much Indiana's new abortion law could cost the state, as we talk with State Rep. Greg Porter of Indianapolis and State Senator Liz Brown of Fort Wayne. All that, plus Mike Pence back on the trail and back in the news, but what are his plans for 2024? It's all ahead right now on this week's edition of In Focus.
Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Dan Spieler, just about 2 weeks away now from the midterm elections. And this year, abortion remains one of the defining issues this election cycle. We'll get a recap of the U.S. Senate debate coming up and a preview of our forum with the Senate candidates. But first, some exclusive reporting from our State House reporter, Kristen Eskow, on the cost of the state's new abortion law, which is currently held up in the courts. As Kristen discovered this week, the law could cost the state millions of dollars.
During the two-week special session this past summer, lawmakers on both sides of the aisle said they anticipated additional costs to the state following the passage of a near-total ban on abortion. They approved roughly $75 million in social services funding as a starting point, but a fiscal analysis from the nonpartisan state budget agency predicts more funding would need to come out of the state's general fund. This previously undisclosed document, which we obtained through a public records request, estimates the cost of the Attorney General's office to defend the abortion ban adds up to $2.75 million over the next three fiscal years. And with more Hoosiers being born, the state budget agency estimates roughly $55.8 million in that same time frame for health care coverage from Medicaid, CHIP, and HIP. Democrats like State Representative Greg Porter accuse Republicans who pushed for the abortion law of not being forthcoming about the potential financial impact.
We just needed more transparency. It should have gone through Ways and Means and deliberately discuss what the impact was going to be. And we did not do that.
Porter is particularly critical of the cost the state would face defending the law in court. He argues it's funding that could be used elsewhere.
We're dealing with teacher pay. We're dealing with infant mortality, morbidity.
But Republican State Senator Liz Brown argues those additional costs will be funds well spent.
I'm happy to fund more moms and babies through our HIP and CHIP programs.
Brown points out nearly $60 million would be a very small part of the state's budget across 3 years. She says those projections aren't a surprise to her, but she believes they're too high. She says the state has the funding needed to cover these costs and additional social services as well.
We are making sure that when we say that we're pro-life, we are pro-life from the beginning, and we're going to fund these programs, and these programs are successful.
From the Indiana State House, I'm Kristen Eskow.
All right, Kristen, thank you. The abortion issue also front and center this week as Democrats gathered at the State House to unveil what they called a contract with women ahead of this year's midterms.
Choice is on the ballot. Supporting our teachers in public schools is on the ballot. Gun reform is on the ballot. LGBTQ rights is on the ballot. So please vote. Vote like your life depends on it, and vote like your rights depend on it.
Now, the very next day, President Biden announced his plan to send a bill to Congress next year to codify abortion rights into federal law if Democrats pick up enough seats in Congress to make such a move.
If we do that, here's the promise I make to you and the American people. The first bill that I will send to the Congress will be to codify Roe v. Wade.
Meantime, Republicans are hoping to take back control of Congress this November, at least the House, as they keep the conversation squarely focused on the economy and the impact of inflation.